Hello dear students, welcome to my next video. This video is on construction chapters MCQs class 10th standard. Let's start. The question number one is, there are total 6 questions are there, but we'll discuss more than 10 questions or 10 to 15 questions we will discuss during the solution of these 6 questions. Keep in mind. So let's start. In a given figure with sides 5 cm, 6 cm and 7 cm. Now keep in mind, always the length which is more, we have to take that as base. Yes, 7 cm is more. So I have taken that 7 cm is base, then another 2 sides 5 cm and 6 cm. And another triangle whose sides are 7 by 5 of the corresponding sides of the first triangle. We have to draw one triangle and we have to draw a similar to this triangle one more triangle in this question. Find the distance BC dash BA dash, this distance BA dash and C dash A dash, C dash and A dash. We have to find these 3 distance. Let's see how to find it. It's very simple, students. What we need to do is to get this length. We know this triangle is divided in the ratio 7 by 5. What we need to do to get BC dash, okay, I am writing BC dash is equal to, the ratio is 7 by 5. I have to write this ratio into this value BC into 7, which is equal to 7 7s are 49 divided by 5. Now 5 1s are 5, 9s are 45, 4 remains, then 0, 5 8s are 40. So we got this BC dash. Now let's see what is the value of BA dash. BA dash is equal to, same student, 7 by 5 as it is, into this value, AB value. Into AB is 5. This 5 I get cancelled, 7 cm. This is 9.8 cm. Then C dash A dash. C dash A dash is equal to 7 by 5 into CA. That is 6. 7 6 are 42 divided by 5. 5 1s are 5 8s are. 5 8s are 40, 2 remains, 0.054 is 28.4 cm. The C is the right option. Here we solved for BC dash, BA dash and C dash, A dash. For 3 values we have solved. In the exam, only 1 or 2 values may also ask. Keep in mind, only BC dash. If we ask only BC dash, you have to find only this and you have to check which one is the right option. In this question, we will discuss some more questions, student. This BX is called as ray. BX is called as a ray. See here. And the angle form is here. The angle form is acute angle, student. Acute angle. This question may ask in multiple choice question. The angle between C dash A B and X is, the angle is acute angle, student. On B, in the whenever you draw this ray, you have to draw this ray on acute angle, students. Keep in mind, this question can be asked in multiple choice questions. We know acute angle is angle between 0 to 90 degree is acute angle. And some more questions are there. Here The question may be like this. What is the ratio of BC divided by BC dash? What is the value of this? We know the BC form by dividing this in 5 parts. B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. So, this will be BC is 5. Now, BC dash, this one is formed by dividing this line into 7 parts. Divided by 7. So, BC by BC dash is 5 by 7. The value of this can also be asked in the annual exam in multiple choice question. Also keep in mind this ray, when you make these parts, how these parts came, B1, B2, B3. Here we have to divide, we have to draw the triangle in the ratio 7 by 5. Now we have to see in this fraction which is the greater number. The 7 is the greater number. So we make 7 parts of this line BX. And also keep in mind these parts are divided into equal parts. The parts are equal, means B1 and B2 is equal to B2 B3, which is equal to B3 B4, which is equal to B4 B5. So all these parts are equal parts. This may also come in multiple choice questions. Keep in mind these parts are 7 parts are divided into equal parts. Now next question, and one more thing, BC divided by BC dash is also equal to B5 into B5 divided by B5 and B7. Okay, BC and B dash, BC dash is also equal to B5 divided by B7. So the many multiple choice question may arise from this figure. You should know what are those questions. I explain. If you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. I will explain one more time. Now let's move to second one question. Second question is, how many tangents can be drawn to a circle from an external point? What he is saying, one circle is there, and how many tangents can be drawn to a circle from an external point? One tangent and another tangent. So student, keep in mind there are only two tangents. Suppose this is O, this is P, this is A, this is B. PA, PB are the two tangents. Keep in mind there are only two tangents can be drawn to a circle from an external point. So our answer is B, only two. Now let's see the question number 3. In the figure, the length of tangent AP is, student, if this is 90 degree, we know this is 90 degree, okay? From the theorem 4.2, we know this is 90 degree. If this is 90 degree, this is adjacent side, this is hypotenuse, and this is opposite side. Now, we know the Pythagoras theorem. By using Pythagoras theorem, we can find the value of AP. This is hypotenuse. OP square is equal to OA square plus AP square. OP square is 10 square, OA square is 6 square plus AP square. Now 10 square is 100, 6 square is 36. When you transfer, it will be minus 36 is equal to AP square. Now this will be 64 is equal to AP square. Now when you transfer this value, it will be under root of 64, that will be 8. Our answer is B, 8 centimeter. Now next question is student, question number 4. To draw a pair of tangent to a circle, okay, pair of tangent to a circle, one circle is there and pair of tangents are drawn to that circle, okay, these are the two pair of tangent drawn to a circle which are inclined to each other at an angle of 35 degree, inclined to each other at an angle of 35 degree. It is required to draw tangents at the end point, okay, here and here, of those two radii, these two radii, one radii and another radii. Radii of the circle, the angle between which is, means the this angle he is asking how much. We know sum of the quadrilateral is 360 degree, right? Suppose this is O, this is A, this is B and this is P. We know angle A plus angle O plus angle B plus angle P is equal to 360 degree, and in this angle A we know from theorem 4.2 this is 90 degree and this is also 90 degree. So angle A is 90 plus angle O we have to find out is 20 according to the question, then plus here it is angle B. Angle B is how much? 90 degree. Then angle P is 35 degree, which is equal to 36 degree. Now we have to find the angle O. Angle O is equal to, transfer all the values to right hand side. 360 degree minus 35 degree minus 90 degree minus 90 degree. When you subtract, you will get 145 degree. So D is the right option for this question, students. Suppose here 60 is given. So it will be minus 60, then whatever answer, that is the angle of O. Here angle O is 145 degree. The values may be different in exam, you should know how to find it, that is important. Now question number 5. To divide a line segment AB in the ratio 5:7, what is saying? One line is there and that line segment is divided in the ratio 5:7. First array AX is drawn so that BX is an acute angle. I'm drawing here, student, see here what is saying. One line segment, that is AB, in the ratio 5:7, when you are dividing the line segment, student, that time you have to add these two value to draw this ray, and whatever the sum of these two value, we have to make that much of part of this line, this ray AX. Like in the first question we have discussed, in this question we have, what we have discussed, when you are forming a similar triangle in this type of question, what we do, we have to take the greater value. The greater value is 7 in that question, and we have divided the ray BX into 7 parts. Here we have to divide the line segment into 12 parts. because here we are not forming a similar triangle, we are dividing a line segment. When you are dividing a line segment, that time you have to add and divide this ray into that parts. When you add these two, it will be 12. The 12 parts, equal parts, we have to make on AX. First ray AX is drawn so that BX is an acute angle. This is acute angle. And then at equal distance, points are marked on the ray AX such that minimum number of these point is. The minimum number of point is asking. Minimum number of points are 12. We have to add, and that much of points we have to add there. Our answer for this question is 12. When you add 5 and 7, it is 12. So D is the right option, student. This is very important. Keep in mind, I'm saying one more time. If it is problem of forming a similar triangle, in that question we have to take the greater value, and whichever is the greater value, that much parts we have to draw on the ray AX or BX, whatever the ray distance is. And if it is line segment, then we have to add both the ratios. Like in this question, 5 is to 7 is the ratio. We have to add both. Whatever we get, that is the, that much of parts we have to make on this ray AX. Keep in mind. Now, sixth one question is to construct a triangle similar to a given triangle ABC with its side 8 by 5 of the corresponding sides of the ABC. Draw a ray BX. Draw a ray BX. We know this is acute angle, and we have to make, see what is the greater number. 8 is the greater. In 8 or 5, 8 is the greater. So we have to make 8 equal parts here. Draw BX such that CBX is an acute angle. Okay, this one. And X is on the opposite side of A with respect to BC. The minimum number of points to be located at equal distance on ray BX is. So this is problem of similar triangle, correct? In that, how many points we can locate here? Here we have to see the which is bigger in these two. The 8 is the bigger. So we can locate 8 equal parts. We can locate 8 equal parts on BX. So 8 is the right option. I hope you understood. If you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel Technical Mathematics. Thank you for watching my videos.